Hello students, good morning. I am going to explain experiment 4. Here the object is to determine the focal length of a convex lens by one pin method using an optical bench. For theory, let's go for a conception. If an object is kept at the focus of a convex lens, the reflected rays become parallel to the principal axis. These refracted rays, if fall normally on a plane mirror, get reflected back on the lens and retrace their path and form an inverted image on the object itself, as shown in the below diagram. Look here. Here, this is a convex lens. O is the optical center of the lens, AB as if the principal axis. On the principal axis, I have taken one point F, that is principal focus. From this principal focus, I have drawn two rays, ray 1 and ray 2. This ray 1 gets refracted and forming refracted ray and falling on the mirror perpendicularly, again it retraces back and come back to in its same position. Similarly, the second ray also falling on the lens after refraction through the lens gets refracted, becomes parallel and falling on the plane mirror normally, again it retraces back and comes back to the same position. So we'll see, that means the object is also here, image is also here. What we'll see in the experiment? It is an optical bench. On this optical bench, there is a holder that is called lens holder. There is another holder. On this holder, we have fixed one pin. This is called pin holder. And there is another holder, third holder, on which a plane mirror is kept vertically upside. Now, on the optical bench, there is graduation. This graduation in centimeter and in millimeter. Have a look. In the optical bench, there is a graduation of centimeter and millimeter. Means 1 centimeter is divided into 10 equal divisions, each small division is 1 millimeter. For the first observation, to get the reading, let's put the lens at 25 centimeter mark. Have a look. The lens is kept at 25 centimeter mark. Now, we have to see through the lens the image of the object. This is the object and we will see the image will be just above the object pin. This is the object pin and here the image will come, that is the image pin, the virtual image will come. Okay, now we have to see the different position. And while you are changing the position of the pin, we have to remove the parallax. Parallax means when you move your eye towards left and right, the pin, object pin and the image pin should not leap to each other. They will coincide each other. Okay. I have removed the parallax and have a look here. The image is just above the object. Look here, the upright pin is the object, whereas the inverted image is formed just above the tip of the object. And when you look at through the lens, we see these two pins, they never leave each other. That is called, there is no parallax. That means parallax is removed. Okay, now we have to record the object pin.
See the position of the object pin. Here the position of the object pin is located at 44.4 centimeter mark. Look here, this mark is coinciding with the this line. So this is 44.4 mark. So here object pin is located at 44.4 centimeter marking.
Now put the values of position of lens, which is so called x1, here 25 centimeter. Position of pin x2, here 44.4 centimeter. So focal length of the lens is here x2 minus x1 means 19.4 centimeter. By doing the experiment, we have seen when the position of the lens is kept at 30 centimeter mark, that time position of the pin we got at 49.6 centimeter. So that this observation we have seen the focal length equals to 19.6 centimeter. For the next observation, when the position of the lens is kept at 35 centimeter, we have seen the position of the pin comes at 54.9 centimeter mark. So focal length this time 19.9 centimeter. Next observation, when we keep the position of the lens at 40 centimeter mark, position of the pin comes at 60.2 centimeter mark, and focal length comes this time 20.2 centimeter. And for the last observation, we have seen when the position of the lens is at 45 centimeter mark, we have seen the position of the pin comes at 65.2 centimeter, and focal length this time 20.2 centimeter. So the mean focal length after doing the calculation we have seen it is 19.9 centimeter. So we can say the result of the experiment, the focal length of the given lens is 19.9 centimeter. While you are doing experiment, let me talk about few precautions. Precautions that, as I told you before, there should not be any parallax. Means if this is the tip of the object, then the tip of the image should come here. They should not be like this. They should be all the time keeping together, right? This position is called there is no parallax. And the second precaution is that while you are doing the experiment, make sure that the tip of the object and the optical center of the lens should be in the same horizontal position. Otherwise, the experiment may not be so accurate. Thank you.